Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we are going to talk about SearXNG or searching. Perhaps we could pronounce it like, and that's much easier than SearXNG. I'm gonna say it a lot in this video. We're gonna install it from scratch in a Debian environment. So if we switch over to my screen here, I have a Debian environment that is just installed as it is. No extra packages, no extra in this installation. The only thing I've added is SSH, so I can log into it. But other than that, it's a base image with no extra packages. So this is a server image where I want to install searching. So first off, we're gonna see that we are up to date. So run update and upgrade. And we're gonna give a QWERTY on my default password here. And this is a tricksy installation. So it will install some Intel microcode here. Nothing that important. But now we're gonna install a bunch of packages. So the next is sudo apt-get install y. So we say that, yeah, just answer yes. Python dev, of course, Python Babel. Python environment, so we can set up an environment because we need to add a couple of extra Python packages that are not available, or we need newer versions of them than actual available in this distribution. Python is Python 3, UWSGI, and the plugin for Python for that. We need Git, build essentials, libxlslt for XML work, and we also need zlib for packing things, of course, zlib, and then we have libffi, I don't really know what that is, and then we have libssl for that kind of traffic. So these packages will take a little while to install, so I'll get back to you when that is done. And there we have all those packages installed. So now we need a user for this privacy respecting metasearch engine. So we run user add with the shell of bin bash. We want it to be a system account. We want it to have the home directory of usr local searching. And then the comment, of course, privacy respecting metasearch engine. And then the name of the account. Of course, some of these are not required, but it looks good in the passvd file. And then we want to create a new directory, this directory which is going to be our home directory. And last but not least, we need to set the permissions. So the change owner recursively for searching to searching the group and the user, and then the directory. So now that we have that, we want to create some configuration, and we will put those in etc. So we're gonna create a searching directory there, and then we're gonna create a settings YAML file. And this YAML file, we're gonna copy paste in here. So there's the searching settings, use default settings, so use whatever is in the package. Currently, I have debug true, so I can see if I have any problems, but that you can turn on later. I give the instance the name searching, and then we have search, save search 2, and then auto complete .go. And then we have the formats that we're going to return in our API. So I've said that HTML, of course, because we want to see it in the GUI. And when we are calling it from LibreChat, for instance, we want to use JSON. So both of those should be enabled. And we also need a secret key if we want to use this API. So no one outside our network will be able to use this service. We'll not put any limiter on this because we are using it locally. We can have it as an image proxy, so we can actually fetch images through it. And then we set the port and the bind address to this local machine, and we don't want to use an eval key. If you want to install that and set that up, of course, you can set the URL here, but I'm not going to use a eval key. So that is everything we need to do in that configuration. Next up, we're going to do some installation. of this. So first off, we're going to jump over to that user with sudo. And now that we have that, we want to clone our Git repository. So we're going to clone searching to usr local searching source. So we're going to copy that over here. And all of this in the script will be in a write-up later, so you can just copy-paste the code. You don't need to keep notes during this presentation. And then next up, we're going to switch over to an environment here. So we do Python 3-m for module, vm, and then we do this particular directory, usr local searching pyenv, and there is where we will have our Python environment, and then we will activate that Python environment using source. And that means that we get that environment, and in that environment we can install extra packages. We will jump over to our source directory, and then I want to install a couple of packages that for some reason is not included in the installation directory here, because there is a file in this directory called requirements.txt, and we're going to use that to install a bunch of things. But we need to add a couple more things. We need to upgrade pip, always a good thing to do, set up tools, and that is to build wheels, and also wheel, of course, so we have that compressed type, YAML support, and also message spec. So we're going to install those extra packages. That will take a little while, but those are installed now. And then we will install the rest. So this is pip install, use pip 5.17, and then no build isolation, and then use the current directory as our environment. And now we'll install a bunch of extra packages that are required for searching. And it's a lot of, it's 38 in the downloads, but the installation is pretty quick. So now we can set our configuration here, the setting. So we will set an export variable, searching settings path to etc searching settings YAML, the file that we created. And then we want to run Python SearchX web app. And it will start our web app on port 8888. So if we go over here and reload, we see that we have searching and we can start using it. But I want to put this into a service instead. So if we now just checking that this is not running, web app, so it should be turned off. Now we want to create a little script for starting this. So I will put this script in usr local searching and call it searching.sh. So this is going to be a bash script, and I'm going to do that outside of this user, of course. So this script is exactly what we wrote before here. So we will enable our current environment. We'll jump over to the source directory and start the service. So nothing strange there. And we want to give this executable permissions. So change modification and do plus X for execute. And then we want to set the user permissions and group permissions for that particular script. So the owner is correct. And then we want to create a service. So we just create a file in etc systemd system called searching.service. And we're gonna copy paste this service. And it's not that much complicated stuff. So we have a description here, searching service, network, online, multi-user target as the one that want to use this. Environment, we set our environment variable here for the setting. And then we want to this runtime directory to be searching, so that is for our PID. We want to use a simple type, so it's just starting and killing the service. User should be searching and groups should be searching, and then we want a timeout to the start second forever. So we won't stop if it's aren't able to start for 10 seconds or something like that. If it fails, restart always and then restart after 10 seconds. PID file will be put into run searching.pig and then PID. And then last but not least, we have our execute start, the actual script that we want to run. So now we should have our service available. So we want to do a daemon reload. So we reload that configuration. After that, we can start our service. We can enable the service so it will start on boot. And last but not least, we will run a status to see that it's up and running. And now we can see that this is active and no issues there. If we jump over here and search, we can see what is the Studio 7780s known for. Do a search there. And it will find the PT video game here on Wikimedia and so on. So this will do a search on a bunch of different search engines and report them back. So we can see here that we got Brave's and Startpage and DuckDuckGo gave us this result. And we see if we can get any other Startpage. No, mostly those are the search engines that we'll use here. And if we look at our preferences, we can see here that we have some general preferences for images and so on. But under engines, we can see what things we have turned on. So we have currency, Dictzone, we have Brave, DuckDuckGo, and Google. So Google could be used if we want to, and so on. So you can turn on and off different search engines here and enable different kind of search for your use case. In my case, I will use this for LibreChat, and in that case most default settings will be fine. Maybe I will disable and enable some different engines later on if I find that the results will not be as good for me. This search meta search engine could be used at your main search engine if you want to have a privacy for forward way or respecting way to do your searches and not give away too much of your personal information. Install a searching interface here on your local network and you can run that as your search engine. So this was what I wanted to cover today. I hope that you found this interesting. I hope that you learned something today. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you have any comments or suggestions, leave those in the comment section down below. And I really hope to see you in the next video.